Let's take a look now at some observations of reactivity and regioselectivity in the Diels-Alder reaction and see if we can draw some conclusions about how the reaction might proceed mechanistically. So the first observation you see here at the top of this slide is that dienes that are locked in this S-trans conformation, in which the double bonds are on opposite sides of the single bond, as opposed to the S-cis conformation, in which both double bonds are on the same side of the single bond, as I've drawn here, is unreactive in the Diels-Alder reaction. So the diene must be present in the S-cis form in order to react in the Diels-Alder reaction. And remember that the new sigma bonds are formed on the ends of the pi system. So this suggests that perhaps the formation of the sigma bonds is concerted so that both ends of the diene have to be close to the dienophile at the same time in order for the reaction to occur. Of course, this would be impossible for the S-trans diene locked in that conformation because the ends of the conjugated system are very far apart. The second set of observations to notice right below is that the Diels-Alder reaction, in the absence of any polarizing substituents, is very slow. So the very basic parent Diels-Alder reaction is very slow. But when we add electron withdrawing groups to the dienophile, as I referred to in the last webcast, the reaction speeds up substantially. And in fact, if we add a Lewis acid to the dienophile to pull even more electrons away from that double bond, the reaction is faster still. So this suggests that polarizing the substituents has an effect on the reaction rate. What you should also consider is that polarizing substituents affect the orbital energies of the diene and dienophile. And remember that high-energy HOMOs and low-energy LUMOs are more reactive. Consider what happens, for instance, to the dienophile LUMO when we add an electron withdrawing group. This lowers the LUMO substantially, making the dienophile much more reactive than just a basic alkene without any electron withdrawing groups. We can do the same to the diene by adding electron donating substituents in order to raise the energy of its highest occupied molecular orbital. That's the origin of the rate effects that you see here. Now let's take a look at the regioselectivity of the Diels-Alder reaction of two substituted components. Notice that there are two possible products of the reactant shown at the top of this slide. In the product at the bottom left, the electron withdrawing group on the dienophile and the electron donating group on the diene are right next to each other, and we call this the 1-2 or ortho product. On the right, you see the 1-3 or meta product, in which the electron withdrawing group on the dienophile and the electron donating group on the diene are now three carbons apart. So which of these products will be formed in higher amounts? Really, it boils down to where the highest orbital coefficients are on the diene and dienophile. These will be the atoms that will tend to want to combine because the orbital overlap between those lobes that are the largest will be the best. Without delving too much into the orbital considerations, though, you can think about resonance structures of the diene and dienophile and identify the most positive and most negative atoms in these structures based on those resonance structures that you drew. So in the diene, for instance, we see we have a lone pair on the oxygen that can be donated into the pi system. And if we do that and draw the resulting resonance structure, what we see is that the far end of the diene away from the electron donating group is likely to be the most negative atom in that structure. On the other hand, if we take a look now at the diene, we notice that an electron withdrawing acyl group can accept electrons into the carbonyl oxygen. And so if we draw a resonance structure to reflect that by pushing electrons towards the carbonyl oxygen, what we see is that, again, the terminal carbon of the pi system is the one that's the most positive. Now, to decide on the likely Diels-Alder product, all you have to do is imagine combining or connecting the most negative carbon on the electron-rich diene with the most positive carbon on the electron-poor dienophile. And in a rather extravagant pushing of arrows, we can imagine pushing arrows like so to accomplish the Diels-Alder reaction between these two resonance structures. And if we do that, we see that the 1-2 product is now favored substantially over the 1-3 product at right. Before continuing on to the next webcast, take a look on your own at the reaction between a slightly differently substituted diene substituted on one of the inner carbons with the same dienophile, and using those same resonance considerations, see if you can determine which product will be favored, the 1-3 product, in which there are 1-2-3 carbons between the substituents, or the 1-4 product, in which we turn over the diene so that the substituents end up para to each other in the final Diels-Alder adduct.